You know how slow Krita 2.9 can be, especially with launch documents. Here, I'm in the animation beta release, creating a 4K by 4K image. I pick a resource-intensive brush and there you go, instant preview. That's one of the two major new features added to the upcoming third version of Krita. This was one of the Foundation's 2015 main Kickstarter goals, and they did a really good job with it. It took a major rework of Krita's core rendering engine. The software is now able to handle big calculations in the background while you keep working like normal. This feature works with the freehand brush tool, geometric tools, the move tool, animation and the filters, but not the filter layers. This is great for the latter as you now get much more responsive HSL adjustments or RGB curves, for instance. Here's how you can try it out for yourselves. First of all, ensure that you have up-to-date graphic drivers that support OpenGL 3.0. In Krita, in the settings menu, go to Configure Krita and then to the Display category. Check that the OpenGL option is on and that you have the high-quality filtering mode available. Then, you need to download the Krita 2.9 Animation Edition beta. It is available for Windows and Linux. Once you have installed and launched it, open a large document and press Shift-L to toggle the instant preview on and off. You can also find it at the bottom of the Edit Brush Settings panel. Please keep in mind that this version is for testing purpose only. It may still be unstable, so don't use it for any important work. So, how does it work exactly? Krita gives you a preview of any of your brush strokes depending on your zoom level. This means that this feature is beneficial if you're below 100% zoom level. Krita will only update the pixels that are visible on your canvas at your current document scale. Then, it will render the final stroke in the background while you keep working at the speed of light. Instant preview has a few limitations. One is that anything that's random cannot be previewed accurately, so instant preview will not work with the brush fuzzy parameters, for instance. Apart from that, the main limitation right now in beta is that the undo function cannot be used while strokes are being processed. The undo history is only populated with a stroke once it has been calculated, so before that, there is nothing to undo. This means that if you're going to work fast on a print size document or with a slow brush for an extended period of time, you will have to do forward painting for a moment to keep the flow going, a bit like a traditional artist. Regardless, it is a huge and more than welcome improvement to the software. It makes painting in Krita even more enjoyable than before, especially if your computer isn't too powerful. That's it for this preview of the upcoming instant preview in Krita. For an overview of the animation toolset, head on to the next video. Thank you for watching.